There have been rumours for the last year or so about cancer. I seem to remember there was an announcement a year or so ago about a heart attack. So around that, within the music community, we knew there was something untoward going on.
When we think about his influence, his contribution, where to start?
That's just incredible, isn't it? The fact that it spans, you know, 4 or 5 decades of consistently amazing, you know, groundbreaking music. It's kind of unprecedented, really, that he was still making music right up to the bitter end. So it's not just, you don't look at one era with David Bowie, you look at this, you know, half a century. It's just incredible.
Somebody described him today as a time lord. They wrote on Twitter, "We found Bowie at different times and all met a different person."
That's right. Yeah, he was. I think he was quite possibly the first person ever to engage us with this kind of theatrical rock thing. You know, he invented a persona. So he invented the Thin White Duke, or he invented Ziggy Stardust. And he was the puppeteer. He was the manipulator behind that character. And not many people would do something like that, achieve the huge success he had with Ziggy Stardust, and then kill it at its peak. You know, he was so powerful.
What was it like to see Ziggy perform?
Oh, glorious. I mean, as a young musician in Glasgow, going to see the original Ziggy and the Spiders playing that album at the Glasgow Apollo was just phenomenal. He did 2 shows, and I went to the afternoon show, which was only half full. So I'm sitting watching this amazing thing happen. I've seen him many times over the years, but that was so powerful and influential in what I did.
And what was it like to perform with him on the same stage as him?
Well, I only did it once. I mean, it was on...
Most people can't say that. That's true.
Like most musicians, you have a fantasy. Wouldn't it be great standing next to him, you know, on stage? And I did at one of the Prince's Trust concerts, but he performed at Live Aid. And we were so pleased that he was there. Because it wouldn't have been Live Aid without him.
I mean, what a stellar performance. We saw him with Mick Jagger, and also performing the Band-Aid song, which famously that first line was written for him, but he just couldn't fit it into his commitments.
Yeah, it was very difficult getting the artists together there, but we did ask him to come along and present the first ever showing of the video, which he did. He was in London at the time, and Bob and I just kind of cornered him in a restaurant and said, you have to do this for us. And of course he did, you know, he was phenomenal. We needed someone with that kind of power and status and gravitas to give the video the kind of opening that it needed. And he was just phenomenal, he was wonderful.
It was a real pinch yourself moment watching him perform.
A pinch yourself moment just being in the same room as him. You know, it's not very often you get to meet your heroes. And it's not very often, if you do meet them, that you're actually quite pleased you met them. He was everything you would hope to be him to be. He was humorous and warm and incredibly kind and generous.
A devastating day for any music fan, especially Bowie fans. What about those who don't see themselves as a Bowie fan? There will be many artists, musicians, bands that wouldn't be here today without his influence.
Oh, absolutely. Whether they know it or not, so it could be a subliminal influence. The way music was created and performed, the whole persona thing, there wouldn't have been, Damon Albarn would have never done Gorillaz if David Bowie hadn't done Ziggy Stardust. Mm. So the idea of presenting this thing, it changed music forever, just as much as the Beatles and George Martin changed music forever.
And do you think that with Black Star, it was almost him controlling his death in the same way he controlled his career?
I think there's been, they've known for a while this was coming. And I think it's quite telling that Black Star was released without the same aplomb as the previous album. Mm. It was kind of slipped out on his birthday. And it's quite an ominous record, I believe. So I think it was his final statement. There's a fantastic tweet from Morgan Visconti, who's the son of Tony Visconti, who produced the album. And Morgan says on his tweet, the last words that David said to me was, "Another day, another adventure." And maybe that's how we have to look at it. He's gone off on his final adventure.